The following is a class on the Bhagavad Gita as it is, second chapter, text number 2, given by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Prabhupada, recorded on the 11th of December, 1972, in Ahmedabad, India.
On Arjadushtam, not at all befitting a man who knows the progressive values of life. Aryan means who are progressive. So, this dejection of Arjuna in the battlefield is described as defeating a non-Aryan. Aryan, according to Aryan civilization, as described in the Bhagavad Gita, there are four divisions inaugurated by the Supreme Personality of Godhead. As you have already explained, dharmam tu sakshat bhagavatani. Any systematic religious process is to be understood. It is given by God. Man cannot make any religious system. So, this Aryan system, progressive system, is Chatudvarnam Maya System Guna Karma Vibhava. Krishna says, it is introduced by me for very good management of the social order. Brahman, Kshatriya, Vaishya, Shudra. So, Arjuna belongs to the Kshatriya family. Therefore, his hesitation to fight in the battlefield is not befitting the Aryan. For the royal order to become non-violent, this is not good. The Kshatriyas, when they are fighting in the battlefield, their killing is not a sin for them. Similarly, a Brahmana, when he is offering sacrifice, sometimes animals are sacrificed, so that does not mean that he is committing sin. This animal sacrifice was made not for eating the animal. It was for testing the Vedic mantra, whether the Brahmanas who were engaged in offering sacrifice, whether they were chanting the Vedic mantra in right way. That was tested by offering one animal and again giving the animal a new youth life. That was animal sacrifice. Sometimes horses, sometimes cows were offered. But in this age, Kali Yuga, they are forbidden because there is no such Jagrit Brahma. All kinds of sacrifices are forbidden in this age. Asvamedham gavalambham sannyasam palapaitritam devarena sutatpatti kalau pancha vivarje. Asvamed sacrifice, gomed sacrifice, sannyas, and to get child by deva, husband, younger brother, these things are forbidden in this age. So, it was the duty of the Kshatriya to fight. Therefore, Krishna is condemning his behavior, that this is not defeating a Kshatriya. By this action, you will be defamed. Afisti Karamarjuna. You are such a nice fighter, soldier, and if you cease to fight, then the other party will defame you in so many ways. What you are thinking of? Especially, you are my friend. I am standing here, despite my becoming your chariot driver. If you decline to fight, certainly it will be a great havoc. Don't do this. Therefore he says, anarjadishtam asargam. Asargam means he cannot be promoted to the heavenly planet. It is said that a kshatriya who dies in the fight, he is immediately promoted to the heavenly planet. But because he is dying for the good cause, therefore he is promoted. Asargam apitikaram. That is defamation on your part. So, Kloibang Masma Kamapatha Naitat Sai Upapadvati Shudrang Ridayadvallam Takta Uttishtha Parantapa. Parantapa means one who can give trouble to the enemies. It is the duty of the Kshatriya. Enemies, aggressors, they should be killed. There is no Atutai. Atutai means one who is aggressor, one who kidnaps one's wife, one who takes away by force one's wealth, one who sets fire in one's house. These are called aggressors. So aggressors should be killed. Aggressors should be given trouble. So Krishna does not teach unnecessarily non-violence. The Kshatriya becomes non-violent, then the whole state will be in chaos. They must learn how to kill any criminal. He should be immediately killed. Just like Maharaj Parikshit, Arjuna's grandson, when he was touring in his empire, the whole world was at that time, Indian Empire. Not Indian exactly, Bharatvarsha. Now we have imitated some name, Hindustan. But formerly the whole planet was known as Bharatvarsha. So, when he saw that one black man was trying to kill one cow, immediately he took his sword. Immediately I shall kill you. Who are you killing cows in my kingdom? This is Kshatriya's business. So, but there is no Kshatriya now, because so many cows are being killed. Nobody is protesting. It is the duty of the Kshatriya to protect every living entity born in the land, in his kingdom. It is not that, as it is going on now, that only the human beings should be protected and not the animals. No animal could be killed except in sacrifice, as prescribed. Unnecessarily, there was no need of killing animals. That is great sin. Sriya sunapana dhuta jatra papas jatravida. Sriya, illicit connection with woman, is sinful life. Unnecessary killing animals, that is sinful life. Intoxication, that is sinful life. Gambling, that is also sinful life. When this Kali was excused, he surrendered himself to Maharaj Parikshit that you have asked me to go out of your kingdom, but where is out of your kingdom? The whole world is your kingdom. So, kindly give me some place where I can stay. So Maharaj Parikshit gave him these four places, that you can stay where illicit sex life is going on. That means prostitution. Unnecessary animals are killed, slaughterhouse. Priyasuna Panaduta, where intoxicants are indulging or gambling, in these four places he can stay. So, at that time Kali could not find now such place throughout the whole world. So he was disturbed. So there was conspiracy to kill Maharaj Parikshit, because the Kali could understand that so long Maharaj Parikshit would live, it is impossible to find out a slaughterhouse or a brothel or a drinking house or gambling place. No. So the kingdom was so nice. We have got description from Srimad Bhagavatam, Maharaj Parikshit, Maharaj Yudhisthira, many. The monarchy was so nice that because they were trained up, Rajarshi, they are not ordinary kings. They are as good as great sages and great saintly persons. Imam Rajarshayo Vidu, Krishna said, Imam Vivasati Yogam Pratamanahamabhyam. Where Krishna said to the sun god, Vivasan, so he says the sun god transfers the teaching to his son Mano, and Mano transfers the teaching to Maharaj Ikkhatu, evam parampara praptam. In this way, the point is that the philosophy of Bhagavad Gita was especially taught to the royal order, because they would know, they should know, because a king is supposed to be representative of God, Naradeva. King is addressed as Naradeva. Even 500 years ago, when Sanatana Goswami was minister of Nawab Hussain Shah, Sanatana Goswami wanted to resign. He wanted to join Chaitanya Mahaprabhu's movement. So when the Nawab understood that Sanatana Goswami, his name was Davir Khan, he changed his name. So he said, no, you cannot resign. Then my whole kingdom will be topsy-turvy. I completely depend on you. So Sanatana Goswami said, my, your majesty, I am no more able to serve you. Kindly excuse me. Then the Nawab said, then I shall punish you. I am Nawab. I am king. So Sanatana Goswami said, yes, you can punish me, because you are representative of God. He never protested, oh, you are Mohammedan, I am this Hindu, or no. He accepted him, that you can punish. The idea is, formally, the monarch, the king, was actually representative of God. They used to rule in such a nice way that nobody was unhappy. During Maharaj Yudhisthira's ruling reign, you'll find in the Bhagavatam that people were so happy that they had no anxiety. Not only they were free from all anxieties, but they had not to bear even scorching heat or shivering cold. No. So as they are so happy, that is the duty of the government. It may be monarchy or democracy, the first duty of the government is to see that all the citizens are feeling happy. That is the duty of the government. Not simply collecting taxes and all the citizens may go to hell, doesn't matter. This is not good government. Good government is to see there are, it may be secular government. The secular government does not mean that the whole citizens should be godless. Secular government should see that even there are many religious sects, such like Hindus and Muslims and Christians. So secular government does not mean that they should neglect. They should see that the Hindus are strictly following the principles of Hindu religion. The Mahavedans are strictly following the principles of Mahavedan religion. That is government's duty. Nobody should remain unemployed. That is government's duty. There are so many things that I all described in connection with Maharaj Prithu, one noble king. So, in Bhagavad, you'll find everything, politics, sociology, religion, culture, philosophy, everything is fine. Vidya Bhagavatam, all kinds of cultural and educational instruction are there in the Srimad Bhagavatam. So, Klabbanma asmak tamapratha naitattattai upapaddhate sudrang didayadadmallam sakta uttishtha parantam. Give up this cowardly habit. Get up and prepare for your fight. This is Kshatriya's business. You should not go behind. Arjuna vacha. Arjuna reply. Katham bhishmam aham sankhe dronam cha madhusudana isubhi pratijasyami pujara barisudana. Now, Krishna was encouraging to fight. Arjuna was also very intelligently replied. He addressed Krishna as Madhusudana, Parisudana. Madhusudana means the killer of Madhu, demon, or the killer of enemy. So his purpose is that I have to kill Bhishma Dev, who is my so kind grandfather, and I have to kill Dronacharya, who is my teacher, from whom I have learned this military art. So, you have killed the demons and your enemy, and why you are inducing me to kill my guru and my grandfather? This is his argument. Katham bhismam aham sankhe dronam cha madhusudana isubhi pratijasvami. They, my grandfather, my teacher, may chastise me, but how I can pierce with arrows their body? So, this is the problem. Duty. Arjuna was forgetting duty. And Krishna was inducing him. Never mind. According to Kshatriya rules and regulation, even the opposite party is your own son. You should not hesitate to kill him. This is Kshatriya's business. If the opposite party is your own son, but when there is fight, then must be decided, one party must be killed. This is Kshatriya's business. So, he says, Gurun Hatyahi Mahanubhava. This Guru, this Dronacharya and Bhishma, they are not ordinary men. Mahanubhava. Bhishma, everyone knows, Bhishma is one of the authorities of religious principle. There are 12 authorities. Sambhu, Narada, Sambhu, Kumara, Kapila, Mano, Bhishma, Prahlada, Janaka, Bhishma, Bali, Vaya, Sakivaya. There are 4, 12 authorities. One of them is Bhishma. Prahlada, Janaka, Bhishma, Bali, Vaya, Sakivaya. So Bhishma is not ordinary person. Therefore he says, Katham gurun hattahi mahanubhavan sreyo bhaktum vaikam apiya loke. I do not like to kill my guru, who is so great, and my grandfather. Better, I shall become a beggar. A Kshatriya's business is not to beg. A brahmana can beg. A brahmana can accept charity. But Kshatriya cannot accept any charity from anyone. Neither he can come down to do business like the Vaishyas. That is not. Everyone should stick to his own principle. If this is followed, Then it is really a secular God. The government must see whether you are claiming as a Brahmana, whether you are actually discharging your duties as a Brahmana. That is secular God. You are claiming as a Kshatriya, whether you are discharging your duties as a Kshatriya. You are a Vaishya, whether you are discharging your duties as Vaishya. This is government's duty. That is Chaturvarnam, Mahasishna. Now they are eager to wash off this social system. They want classless society. But in the material world, there cannot be any classless society. It is not possible. Classless society can be established in the spiritual world. Just like we are propagating this Krishna consciousness movement. This is classless society. Here you will find Europeans, Americans, Indians, Africans, Hindus, Muslims, Christians. But they have forgotten that they are Hindus, Muslims, or Christians, or Americans, or Indians. They are all identifying, you are all servant of Krishna. This is classless society. This is classless society. There is no distinction. Here, a Hindu coming from very respectable Brahmin family, and another man is coming from the dog-eater's family. It doesn't matter. As soon as one becomes Vaishnava, he is classless society. Therefore, it is forbidden. Vaishnave jati buddhi. Atte siladhi gurusu naramati Vaishnave jati buddhi. Naraki. Just like we should not consider this deity before us as made of some metal or wood. No. Atte siladhi. No. Here is the Supreme Personality of Godhead standing. We should take it like that. Otherwise, does it mean that we are offering our obeisances to a metal doll? We have become so fool? No. We take it. Here is Krishna personally standing. That if one cannot feel like that, this Shastra says you should feel like that. Atte siladhi. Guru su naramati. Guru, spiritual master, should not be considered as ordinary human being. Guru su naramati. The Ganges water, one should not think that it is ordinary water. Or charanamrita. These are forbidden. Similarly, Vaishnava jati buddhi. One should not think, he is American Vaishnava, he is Brahman Vaishnava, he is African Vaishnava, he is black Vaishnava, he is white Vaishnava. No. Vaishnava is Vaishnava. Servant of God. Just like in the Ganges water. In Calcutta I have seen so many mill water coming. Sweat ditches water is coming. But when it falls down on the Ganges water, it is no more any other water. Everything is Ganges water. Practically you accept it. In Calcutta, there are many rigid Hindus, Brahmins, they are taking bath in the Ganges. But even stool is floating there. They set it aside and take bath. Ganges water, actually, you see chemically, although so many unclean water is coming there, it is still pure. Similarly, Vaishnava, he may come from any family, it doesn't matter. He becomes immediately transcendental. Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, Manchabhya vicharini bhakti yogi na jasevate sagunan samadritta itan brahma bhuyakal. Immediately. We are trying to become, to understand aham brahmasmi. So, this realization immediately become effective if one is a pure devotee. Manchabhya vicharini bhakti yogi na jasevate. Sagunan samatitta ita. He is above all these three qualities. So, if actually you want to make classless society, then you have to accept this Krishna consciousness. There is no other one. If you make artificially classless society, it will never be effective. The communists are trying to make classless society. The classless society can be formed on spiritual platform, not any material platform. This will be artificial. Pandita Samadarshan, when one is actually advanced in knowledge, advanced in knowledge means one should understand that I am eternal servant of Krishna or God. That is advancement of knowledge. Aham Brahmasmi, I am not this body, I am spirit soul. And Krishna is the supreme soul. I am part and parcel of Krishna. Brahma Bhuta Prasannatma Nasochati Nakanta. Simply by understanding that I am spirit soul, I am Brahma, will not help us. You must act like Brahma. Guna karma vibhagas. There must be realization that is guna. At the same time, there must be practical work. That is Vedic civilization. You should not claim falsely. If you are actually Brahmana, you must act as a Brahmana. If you are a Kshatriya, you must act as a Kshatriya. Guna karma vibhag. Not that I am a Brahmana, now I have become something else. Just like in Calcutta, we are seeing there are small slaughterhouses and they have posted one deity, Goddess Kali, and have got sacred tray and the signboard is, this meat is slaughtered by a Brahman. Therefore it is pure. And that is going on. The meat eaters, they take all this meat and they think it is the prasad of Goddess Kali. And it is slaughtered by a Brahman, there is no sin, it is all right. This is why. No, Brahmana is not meant for becoming a slaughterer, a killer, no. Brahmana should be truthful, Brahmana should be clean, no sinful life. Brahmana should be controlling the senses, controlling the mind. Brahmana must be well-educated, jnana, and he must apply the knowledge in practical life and believe in the Vedic injunction. These are the qualifications of Brahman. Similarly, there are qualifications of Kshatriyas, Vaishyas. We should follow that. And it is the duty of the government to see that this man is claiming as a Brahmana whether he is actually executing the duties of Brahman. That is government. Not that they should simply fight that I am Brahman, I am Kshatriya, I am Hindu, I am Muslim. No. The government's duty is to see that actually whether he is as he claims to be. So, Arjuna says that I do not like to kill my grandfather or my guru, not only ordinary guru. Guru is never ordinary. Guru, that I have explained, never we should consider Guru as ordinary human being. Guru means as king is the representative for giving protection to the people. Similarly, a Guru or Brahmana is also meant for giving protection to the people from spiritual side. The king, Kshatriya, is meant for giving protection to the people from material side. The Vaishya is to produce from material side. Everything is systematically arranged. So, Brahmana means the intelligent class of man. Kshatriya means the administrative class of man. And Vaishya means the productive class of man. And the Shudra means ordinary worker. These divisions are everywhere. You cannot say that only the Brahmanas and Kshatriyas and Vaishyas are in India. No. When it is a creation of Krishna or God, it must be everywhere, in every planet, in every country, every city. Because anywhere you go, either in Europe or America, you'll find some classes are men, very intelligent class. They are interested in philosophy, science. Similarly, there is a class of men who are interested in politics. They are Kshatriyas, you can say. Similarly, there are persons who are interested in making money, Vaishyas, and there are ordinary class of men. They neither Brahman nor Kshatriya nor Shudra. They cannot live independently. Shudra means he must find out a master. A master. Paricharyatmakam karyam Shudra karma sabhav. Shudra's business is to find out a master. That's like a dog. A dog must find out a nice master, otherwise it is a street dog. His condition is not very good. Similarly, Shudra means he must have a nice paying master, otherwise his life is at risk. So, if you consider in that way, the Shastra says, Kalo Shudra Sambhava. In this Kali Yuga, everyone is a Shudra. You hardly find a real Brahmin or a real Kshatriya or Vaishya. Because they are after service. In the Shastra, it is said that a Brahmana, if he is in difficulty, he may take the profession of a Kshatriya or up to a Vaishya, but never take the business of a Shudra like a dog. That is private. And nowadays, we are claiming to become Brahmana and going here and there with application, if there is any vacancy, sir. So these things are topsy-turvy. Simply it has become a farce. Actually, if we want to establish Vedic civilization, then we must follow strictly the principles of Vedas, as it is described in the Bhagavad Gita, and it is practiced. Then, daiva varna samtam. That is required. Daiva varna samtam. There must be the four divisions. Just like we have got four divisions in our body. The head division, the arm division, the belly division, and the leg division. The leg division is the Shudra, the belly division is the Vaishya, and the arm division is the Kshatriya, and the head division is the Brahmin. So these divisions are now lost. Actually, there is no Kshatriya, no Brahmin. Maybe there are some Vaishyas and Shudras. So suppose, if your whole body, there is only belly and leg, then what is the body? If you have no head and no arm, then how it is? What kind of body it is? Therefore, in the social order of the present day, there is no Brahmana nor Kshatriya. Only there are some few Vaishyas and Shudras. Therefore, there is chaos all over the world. So this Krishna consciousness movement is meant for creating some real Brahman. At least there may be head. They are all mad after the influence of the material energy. So there is need of some Brahman who can give advice to the people how to live, how to become God-conscious, how to become happy. There is great need of this movement. Simply, so-called classless society will not help us. That is not Vedic civilization.
Bhogan rudhira-pradidhan.
So, Arjuna is giving his nice argument that if I kill my such great-grandfather and such noble my teacher, then after killing them, if I enjoy this world, it will be mixed with blood and fire. So I cannot fight.
Arjuna clearly declined to fight.
Then again he says, Na chaitat vidma kataranna gadiyo jadva jayema jadivana jayeyu janeva hadyana jiji vishama te avasthitatro mukhe dhatras. He said that after killing my family man,
Dhritarashtra, Dhritarashtra, Pandava. Dhritarashtra and Pandu, they are two brothers. And they are sons, cousin brothers. So, generally, people want to increase his material opulence to show to his friends and relatives. When one person constructs a very nice house, he invites his relatives and his friends to show them that now I have become so opulent. So Arjuna is thinking in that term, that suppose I conquer over and I get the kingdom, that if my relatives and brothers are dead, whom shall I show? This is another kind of vairagya. How this material relationship makes one foolish. Arjuna is playing the part of a foolish man, and Krishna will chastise him, and we shall see later on. Thank you very much. Hare Krishna.
Hiranyakasipu.
The God has taken the shape of Narasimhaswami, and he has made an initial change by carrying his stomach, and then he takes out the intestine and puts his mouth. That is the picture of normal itself. What is the significance and how it is actually, what it is meaning? Whether he is, why he, this part of picture is being given, and everywhere like this in picture, in Qatar, everywhere, right from
my childhood, what does it signify? It is not significant. Keshavadhita narahari rupa tavakara kamalavari nakhamad bhuta singam dalita hiranna kasipu tanu bringam Keshavadhita narahari rupa nishinga rupa jaya jagadishare. So, Krishna assumed the Narahari, Nisinga Rupa, half man, half a lion. So, these are description in the Shastras. Ramadi Mutti Sukalanyamena Tishthan, Nana Avatara Makarad Bhuvanesha Kintu, Krishna Sang Samabhavat, Paramapumanaju, Govindamadi Purusham. So, there is no significance. This Hiranyakasipu wanted to become immortal. Then when he was refused by Lord Brahma that you cannot become immortal, that is not possible. Then in a roundabout way he took benediction from Lord Brahma that he would not die on land, on water, on sky. No weapon can kill him. No demigod talking in this way, roundabout way, he thought, now he has become immortal. So, to keep the words of Brahma as it is, the Lord assumed a form which is not within his description. And instead of killing him with a weapon, he killed him by the nails. Nail is not considered as a weapon. So, he killed him between day and night, because he also took benediction, that I shall not die during day time or night time. So God, Krishna is so intelligent that we may try to become immortal by so many scientific brands, but there will be some flaw and one must be killed. This is God's intelligence.
Biology, they start to study biology or zoology,
right.
Involves killing animals.
Yes. Yes, certainly. You cannot kill even an ant.
Then, you have to study.
That is your business, what can I say? But any kind of animal killing is sin. Sinful. Krishna says, sarva jonishu kaunte asambhavanti muta ya tasang mahajani brahma ahang bija pada pita. Krishna says that I am the seed-giving father of all living entities in any form. Sarvajonishu. Sarva means all. 8,400,000 species and forms. So Krishna is the father. And all living entities are part and parcel of the Lord. They have different dresses according to different karma. But actually, every living entity is part and parcel of God. Sons. So suppose a father has got 10 sons, and one of them or two of them are useless. So if the elder brother wants to make some experiment by killing the younger brother, would the father be pleased? No. Father will be sorry if the intelligent boy is killed or the dull boy is killed. For father, there is no such distinction. Similarly, you cannot kill animals without being sanctioned. That sanction is in the sacrifice.